Charger Dude 95, founder of the DSFL 4. Week 6 of the BTFL season features the 76 Raiders at home in the Bay against the 94 Chargers. Late first quarter, Stabler dials up the deep ball and finds Fred Biletnikoff. The veteran from Florida State reels in his first touchdown of the season, and the Raiders lead 7-0. Then an Atkinson scooping score after yet another Stan Humphries fumble gives the Raiders a 14-0 lead at home. Final play first quarter, leaping catch for 47 from Mark Say. The young receiver from Long Beach State is the team's leading receiver, and that leads to a Kearney field goal. Rookie from Maryland, Rick Jennings. Incredible return of 66 yards. He zigs, he zags, and he weaves his way near for a touchdown. But Stabler could not take advantage of the incredible effort as that pass is intercepted, and the score remains 14-3. Under 2 minutes to go in the half, John Kearney steps in but misses a field goal. Then Errol Mann of the Raiders misses one himself. And the Chargers, with just one win on the season, have a chance to come back and steal this game on the road. Mann's field goal gives the Raiders a 17-3 lead. Diving interception here, then a lost fumble by Stabler. It seems neither offense could get anything going. And on 4th and 21, a man of Natron Means, who has an incredible season coming in, nearly 7 yards a run coming into this contest. DSL to just 24 yards on 11 carries, just over 2 yards a run. And the game-winning touchdown pass by way of Stabler extends the Raider lead to 24-3. Interception by Thomas, and Oakland winds up with a 31-3 win in a game where the Chargers back up all of 5 first downs.
78 Steelers and 69 Chiefs. Len Dawson for the Chiefs starts this one off, leaving the pocket, getting down to the 20-yard line, and the ball's on the turf. Pittsburgh picks it up and runs it all the way to the end zone. The Steel Curtain flexing their muscles early as the Steelers go up 7-0. Len Dawson looking to respond with a pass down to midfield and a field goal by the Chiefs, cutting the Pittsburgh lead to 4. Terry Bradshaw down to Lynn Swan, a diving catch to midfield, and this one goes off the upright and in as Pittsburgh brings their lead back up to a touchdown game. John Starworth with a catch at midfield, and he fumbles. Kansas City picks this one up. Len Dawson on the next play with a touchdown toss, tying this one up at 10. With the game now tied, Terry Bradshaw looking to respond to the same pass to John Starworth. This one, another field goal, breaking the tie. Pittsburgh up 3. And Starworth has just been open on that left sideline all day. This time, he brings it all the way down to, let's say, the 8-yard line. And another field goal makes it 16-10. And this time, Lynn Swan gets them in the red zone. And Franco Harris, the Penn State legend, punches it in, making it 23-10. Len Dawson trying to make something happen. He is intercepted. And then Starworth yet again down that left sideline. This time nobody will catch him. He will get in the end zone. This game was close at half, and they kind of broke wide open. 30-10, Pittsburgh takes this one.
0-2 Buccaneers at 0-8 Cardinals. We start off with a Reggie Williams punt return. It's a fumble recovered by Dirk Johnson. The first touchdown by a punter all season. Do the punter dance. And then Brad Johnson, he redeems that by throwing it to Ken Dilger, and then the A-Train, Mike Allstott, the big guy, is showing off the moves. He makes it into the end zone for a touchdown. Score is tied. Brad Johnson, he throws it to Keenan McCardell, his favorite receiver close to midfield. Michael Pittman gets the ball on the flats pass, but he's injured. He would be replaced by Aaron Stecker. But Mike Allstott, he would do most of the work. He'd have most of the workload here. As the A-Train makes it into the end zone again. Second touchdown. One possession lead for the Bucks. And Mike Allstott, he's showing off the wheels. Gets it close to midfield. He's actually dragging guys into there. Brad Johnson gives it to Keyshawn Johnson. The Johnson-to-Johnson connection. But Brad Johnson is sacked by Gerald Hayes to get him out of field goal range. Edgerrin James, he catches the pass from Kurt Warner. And then Anquan Emboldin, he waits for the ball in the end zone. Score is tied. But Brad Johnson, at the end of the game, he throws it deep. The Johnson to Johnson jumping connection as he makes it into the end zone for the touchdown. Buccaneers have a 7-point lead. Last ditch effort, 4 seconds left. Kurt Warner, he throws it deep to Anquan Emboldin, but he's unable to get it. Scores 21-14 at the end of the game. Buccaneers are 4-2. Cardinals are on a 4-game slide. 99 Rams and 99 Jaguars. These two teams could have played each other in 99. Punt return by Azair Akeem. It's a fumble recovered by Ben Coleman for a touchdown. That puts the Jaguars on the board. Sir Isaac Bruce catches the contested pass, and Kurt Warner shows off the wheels, but watch out, he's tackled. It's a fumble recovered by Lonnie Martz. And then Mark Brunell throws it over the middle to Keenan McCardell, getting the ball into Rams territory. But Mark Brunell is sacked by Grant Winstrom and then throws a mistake interception to Dexter McCleon. Kurt Warner tries to show off those wheels again. He didn't learn from last time as it's a fumble recovered by Kevin Hardy. And then Brunell throws it down the left side. Contested catch by Jimmy Smith, but Brunell fumbles again. Fumble Rooski time. These are contagious by Todd Collins. Torrey Big Game Holt catches the ball over the middle. And then Kurt Warner shows off the wheels. He throws a touchdown to Azair Akeem. And Mark Brunell, he gets tackled, throws deep. Jimmy Smith has to dive for the ball, but he gets a touchdown. Marshall Falk. He's showing off the wheels, getting the ball into Jaguars territory, close to the midfield off of two fourth down plays. But Kurt Warner is sacked by Seth Payne. They got a punt. James Stewart, he helps the Jaguars cause, getting it into Rams territory and then catching Brunell's second touchdown pass of the game over the middle. The Rams lose again. They are 1-5 in a dangerous position. The Jaguars are 3-3.